today's tutorial is going to be based on Daniel Linthwaite's work. He has his Instagram channel by the name BestServedBold, and he has some really great examples on his Instagram and Dribbble. You should definitely check him out. So basically, I think what he's doing is deforming a plane, and he has some other examples here. Yep, this one. So he's deforming a plane, and we have some great reflections going on here. So I'm gonna try and replicate this in Cinema 4D as close as I can. Hope you enjoy this. So let's get started. I've created a new Cinema 4D project and I just added a plane. I'm gonna change the shading to grid shading with lines so we can see the number of subdivisions the plane has. Now, in order to morph this plane into a ripply cloth-like structure, I'm adding a displacer deformer. Let's rename the plane. Now, to drive the deformation of the plane, go to the shading tab and add a noise shader. So as you can see, the plane is a little bit deformed. Now I'll change the type of noise to gaseous. You can try this out with other noise types as well, but after some trials I found gaseous works well for this effect. I'll just increase the plane subdivisions in order to get more geometry so it can be deformed. So right now our gaseous deformer is really, really small, so I'll just increase the global scale. And for the effect we have too much detail, so I'm going to decrease the number of octaves to 1. Okay, now we are getting somewhere. So as you can see, the pattern is static right now. To animate this, all you need to do is just increase the animation speed. You can adjust this based on how fast you want the animation to go. I'm also increasing the total number of frames to 500 to get a longer animation. So we have the basic animation going now. Now comes the fun part, to add the ripple effect. And to do that, you just need to increase the number of cycles. I'm setting it to 2. Okay, the animation is looking good, but there are some jagged edges around the corners. So let's fix that. Now, one way to improve this is by going to the Object tab for the displacer and decreasing the height. We already see some improvement. Another thing we can do is add the smoothing deformer to the plane. Okay, so most of the jagged edges are gone now. You can see if I toggle the smoothing deformer, how it's affecting the plane. So now that we have the animation ready, let's move on to the second part, which is lighting and texturing. I'll be using Octane for rendering, but you can follow the same steps in any other render engine. So first step is to change the render engine to Octane. I'll also adjust the output size to 1080 by 1080, which is standard for Instagram square videos. Now I'll open the live viewer for Octane so we can see what's going on. Now our scene does not have any lights yet, but the scene is too bright due to the environment color. So in the settings tab for Octane, I'll just change the environment color to a very dark blue. Now the next step is to add a lighting source. I'll be doing that using texture environment. in the Octane Objects tab. For the Octane Sky object, we need a new texture. So I'm creating a new image which is 2000 by 2000 pixels using Photoshop. Now all you need to do is just set the background to black and add some rectangles and ellipses with different colors. You can also add some glow to enhance the effect. And you should end up with something like this. Since we'll be using this as an HDRI map, you don't need to be too precise. You can just play around with different shapes and colors. Now I'll just add the image texture that we just created to the Octane Sky. Once the image texture is loaded, you can just refresh the Octane Viewer window and it should display the HDRI map that we just created on the Octane Sky. Now the surface of our plane is not very reflective, so I'll just create a new glossy material and add it to the plane. I'll adjust it so that the diffuse channel is set to black. To get a more reflective surface, we can just increase the index for our plane material. And now we are able to get more reflections on the surface. I'll also increase the roughness a bit, so the edges of those HDRI lights that we created are not so harsh. So I wasn't really liking the texture map that I created, so instead of this one, now I change this to this one, which I used for my original animation. Now all you need to do is find a good camera angle. Let's try to play the animation. Okay, it's looking good. Now to make the material a little bit more interesting, you can add iridescence to the material. And you can do that by modifying the film width and the film index properties, like so. I'll also increase power of the HDRI light in order to make the scene brighter. Now to preview the animation and to check before doing the final render whether the speed is the way you want it, you can do a preview using the hardware OpenGL previewer. And set the size to 320, and it will quickly render a preview of the whole animation, which gives you an idea of the speed and movement of the animation. And this usually saves a lot of time for me, since I don't have to render the whole thing again if I need to change the speed. So you can play the preview back. Okay, it's looking good. So now I'll add a save path so we can save the final render output. And I'm going to be rendering a TIFF sequence. So just in case if the render is interrupted, we can continue from the frame that we left on. I'll change the frame range from single frame to all frames. And now I'll make some changes just to speed up the overall render. Just go to the kernels tab in the Octane settings and reduce the max samples. We don't need a lot of samples for this kind of animation, and most of the polishing can be done in post-processing in After Effects. So I'm just decreasing the sample for a faster render. I'll also disable the alpha shadows to make the render faster. Now it's time to add some bells and whistles to our render. Go to post, enable post, and just add some bloom and glare to the render. This can also be done in After Effects once you have done the final render, but I like doing a little bit of post processing inside Cinema 4D itself. Now to add even more dynamic lighting to our scene, we can do a simple trick. We can just rotate the HDRI sky. I'm adding a couple of keyframes for the rotation and just moving around the HDRI sky. So the lighting in our scene is a little bit more dynamic. So now that we have the animation ready, let's render it. I'll click on Add to Render Queue and click on Start Rendering. Now that the render is complete, we can check all the frames that have been rendered. You can just scroll through these frames to get an idea of how the animation would look. Now let's assemble this animation in After Effects. Now I can import the TIFF sequence that we rendered into After Effects. Click on Import and select the first frame of the sequence. Now drag and drop the sequence onto the new composition button and it should create a new comp with the same size. I'll now add an adjustment layer to my After Effects composition so I can do color correction on the TIFF sequence. So the first step is to adjust the brightness and contrast. I'll increase the brightness and add a little more contrast to the scene. Now I'm adding a hue saturation slider to our adjustment layer. And you can adjust the hue knob to play around with the colors. And this can be used to make the animation a bit more interesting. So I'll add a keyframe for the hue cycle and make some minor changes to the hue over the course of the animation. We can also add the glow effect to our animation, and right now it's too strong, so I'll just reduce it to maybe 0.2. Now I can go ahead and add some text to my animation. So I'll just write create every day, change the color to white, and align the text to the center of the composition. Now that the animation is ready, we can export it. So I'll click on Export and click on Add to Adobe Media Encoder Queue. and this will open up Adobe Media Encoder. And now I can just click on the green play button to start the cue. Once the render is complete, you can click on the output file link to open up the output file.